seen how, you know, how tough time I had on revision. Because during the classes, you all don't speak up. Again, turn to page number 394. Those who haven't turned it on, turn it out. Please turn to page 394. I told you, we have head and we have tail. Heads and one, heads and two, heads three, heads and four. Now, tail and one, tail two, tail three, tail four. So these are eight possible outcomes. The question is, what is the probability the pointer will stop on three? Okay, three, it will only stop one time on three. And also a head, you want three and head together. Like example, Zeeshan is tossing a coin and Judy is, you know, playing with the pointer. I told you that what time you can get head and head to Judy and Zeeshan will get number three. So that's only one chance, head and three. If we do the theoretical probability, so one and eight. Now, what is the probability that the pointer will stop an odd number? Girls, do you know the meaning of odd number? Not multiple of two.
Yes.
It means one and three.
Yeah.
One and three. So it's head ones and heads three. There are two times. This is the first time and this is the second time. So that's why 2/8, when you simplify, you get 1/4. 2/8, when you simplify, you get 1/4.
Miss, but 4 is an even number.
Listen to me. Yeah, what's your name? Zeeshan. Question is, you want odd here when you're tossing. So I got odd number with heads and one. This is odd number. Heads and three. This is odd number. So how many times you get?
Two.
So write two in the numerator. And total, how many outcomes are there? One,
eight.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Total, how many outcomes are there? Total, eight outcomes are there. Total will be always written in the denominator. Whereas the selected are written in the numerator. So when I cancel them two times, when you divide two times one, two times four. So this is my answer actually. They did not say you that in the answer, it must be odd. They just ask you how many odds are there in the table. Yeah, now you will say, me teacher, even tails and one is odd. Yes, it is odd. But did they ask you about the tail? They ask you only about heads.
Heads
on number, okay? Any question?
No.
Now coming to next page. Now guys, this I will try to do on the math exercise. Well, let's just finish this and then do the math exam. Okay. A fair coin is tossed twice. Girls, twice means again. Again, maybe this time, Miral and Dana is there, okay? Both of them are tossing a coin. So either both of them will get head. You can just do this, like you have head and tail, right? Head, 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 tail, or tail, head, and tail, tail. Like girls, this is this way. This is this way. Like example, I write here the names. Miral here, M, and Dana here. Okay? Both are tossing the time. First time, both of them got head. Head, head. Next time, Miral got head and Dana got tail. Next time, Miral got tail and Dana got head. Next time, both got tail. Girls, there is any other possibility I missed it? Just check. Any other possibility that both of them can get? Head and tail, or tail and head, or tail and tail. This is the only possibility Miral and Dana get. They are tossing a coin. Okay, so how many total outcomes are there? HH, TH, HT, and TT. Four outcomes are there. How many are there? Four. Now the question is, find the probability of get exactly one tail. One tail means how many times they got only one tail, one of them got tail. This time, no tail. See, it cannot be this because there is no tail. Yes, this time one of them got tail. Even this time one of them got tail. This time did one of them get tail or two of them got tail? This time two of them got tail. So how many possibilities are there? One of them got tail. How many possibilities? How many possibilities are there that they get tail at one of the girl got tail? How many girls, what is the possibility of getting one tail? Did they get tail in the first time? Did they get tail in the first time when both of them did it?
No.
I cut them.
No.
No. Second time?
Yes.
Yes, I put a tick mark. Third time?
Yes.
Yes. Fourth time, one of them got tail?
Yes.
Got. Not one of them. But the question is, one tail. They don't want two tail. So one tail, how many times? There are two attempts that they got one tail. That's why, right? There are two outcomes that have exactly one tail out of four. So two out of four is half, that is 50%. Any questions here?
No.
The tree diagram shows the sample. Okay, they showed you 2, 6, 7, 9, 6, 2, 7, 9, 7, 2, 6, 9, all that they have shown you. What is the probability of choosing this girls? This, you must read it three times. What is the probability of choosing a number from the sample space that contains both 9 and 6? Sample space, it must contain 9 and 6. 2, 6, 2, 7, 2, 9, this does not contain. It must contain what? 9 and 6. I'll just put a cross mark. 2, 6, 2, 7, 2, 9. Do they have 9 and 6 together? Do they have 9 and 6 together? Girls, 2, 6, 2, 7, 2, 9. Do they have 9 and 6 as a pair? It is 2, 6, 2, 6, 2, 7, and 2, 9. Tell me, do they have 9 and 6 together here, somewhere in this pair? Judy?
Yes.
Pair contains 9 and 6 together. Girls.
No.
Do they make a pair of 9 and 6? This is a pair of 2 and 6.
No.
2 and 7. This is a pair of 2 and 9. Do you have 9 and 6?
No.
Here, 6, 2, 7, 6, 9, 6. Do they have
9 no.
together? 2, 6. It's not there. I'll put a cross mark. 6, 7, cross mark. 6, 9. Do they have 9 and 6?
Yes.
This is 9 and 6. Now come here. 7, 2. 9 and 6? No. 7, 6? No. 7, 9? No. 9, 2? No. 9, 6? Yes. We have one more 9, 6. I put it. Last thing, 9, 7. So how many 9, 6 you have? How many pairs of 9, 6 you have in all?
Two.
Yes, there are two pairs. There are two pairs of 9, 6 out of total. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12. Total, there are 12 outcomes. 2 out of 12. If I simplify 2 out of 12, I get 2 ones and 2 sixes. So my answer is 1, 6. Sorry, 1/6.
Miss, it's not 2/3.
2/3. Why 3, girls? How many total are there?
No, Miss, I mean here it's written 16, then 2/3.
See, how do you get the percentage? Now I have
two. Are you multiply?
Divide 2/3. Let me divide. If I'm using my calculator, I divide 2 over 3. 2 divided by 3, I get 0.66 multiply by 100. I get 66.6%. You can write here, girl, 66.6% instead of this. Write 66.6%.
Okay. 66.28.
Again, letter 6, 2 over 12. Sorry, girls, it's not 66.6%. 2 over 12 times 100. There's something wrong in my division. It's 16.6%, girls, 16.6%.
Okay.
Oof. Any question till here?
No.
Give me a moment, girls. Okay, guys. So till here, you all understood, right?
Yes.
Now next. The table shows the possible outcomes of the spinning given spinner and flipping a fair coin. They are even doing the, like I told you, two of the girls again. Let us take this time Noor and, okay, this time I will take Noor and Zeeshan. Okay. Noor likes to flip a coin. And Zeeshan likes to use the spinner. Okay, spin. Now the first time we have head and tail. So let us say the first time she gets Noor get head and spin, it's like one. So the pair becomes H, comma, 1. Similarly, next time, H2. Next. H3. Next time, H4. And only four times. Next, now they will start getting tails. Noor get tails. And Zeeshan get 1. Noor get tails and Zeeshan get 2. She again get tail and 3. She again get tail and Noor Zeeshan gets number 4 in the spinner. there is any other possibility? Because I told you Noor cannot get number four because she's just using head and tails. And Zeeshan cannot get head and tails. It cannot be 4T. It can be T comma four. Now the question is, landing heads up, okay, they got heads up, and the pointer is landing on one, two, and or four, no three. So heads up and one. Yes, here Noor got heads up and Zeeshan got one. Heads up and two. Yes, here. Heads up and no three. They did not ask for three. They said heads up and four. That's it. Rest all are tail. So it cannot be this. They all are tail. So it cannot be tail, tail, tail. I'll just cut all this. I will not even put a tick mark head and three. Why? Because the question ask is find the probability landing heads up and the pointer landing on one, two, or four. They did not give you three here. Did they give you three here? No. One, two, four. So one, two, and four. So how many girls, total how many outcomes did you get? Total how many outcomes did you get, girls? Zeeshan, when you all played,
yes,
how many outcomes do you get total if you count all of them?
10.
Let us count. Count again.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Why did you say me 10?
I don't know.
Let us see why it is not. Now it is 3. Now, girls, see what I mistake I did. What didn't I do? They ask you, it is from 1 to 5. It's not 1 to 4. So what did I forget? I forget H5. Did you see? I did not write because I want to see who's concentrating here. And T10.
So I was concentrating.
T5, yes. So see, there are more two numbers. There are more two numbers. So there are total 10. And how many got head and 1, 2, 4? 1, 2, and 4. No 3, no 5, and no T5. So there are 3 out of 10. Are you getting the concept, girls? Are you getting the concept?
Yes.
Total, you will write in the denominator. And the outcome, what they're asking us, you will write in the numerator. Noor, did you understand?
Yes.
Miral? Judy, got it?
Yes.
Dana?
Yeah.
Okay, Dana. Now, the organized list shows all possible outcomes when three fair coins are flipped. Okay, there are three. Alhamdulillah, they gave us the space. We don't have to write all this. What is the probability that at least two fair coins land head? We want two H. We want two head. Let us check together when there are two heads. Two heads. That means the third has to be tail. Let us check. Come on. Two heads. There are three heads. At least means, okay, I can take three heads also. Two heads. Two heads. One head I will not take. I will not take one head. This is wrong. This is wrong. And this is wrong. Now, girls, why did I put wrong here? Yes, Dana, why did I put wrong here? Why did I put wrong to this? Because they ask you at least two land head up. Do you have two heads here in the last one? Dana, do you have two heads in the last one? In the last one, tail, tail, tail. There are no two heads. Tail, tail, head. There
no,
are two heads. Tail, head, tail, no two heads. Where you have here, and you have here. So how many outcomes? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Four out of total, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 4 out of 8 is your answer. That is 50%. Okay. If I ask you, what is the possibility of getting only one tail in the, at least one tail. Choose how many are there, at least one tail. Zeeshan, tell me at least one tail. How many there are with one tail in the sample space? Count.
Three.
Okay. Okay. One tail. Let us see. One tail means what?
No, it's 1, 2.
1, 2, 3.
No, miss, this is 2T.
Okay. If I say at least one tail means you can even take 2T. But only one tail means you will take, okay, chalo, we'll take on only one tail. Let's see. Only one tail. How many are there? Let us see.
One here.
No. There is only three. Where is fourth one? Tell me where is fourth one.
No, there is no.
So one, three over eight. So did you get it? How to solve it?
What is it in for? Why?
This is at least LAN head up. I just ask you the question by my own. Here they're asking you LAN held two, at least two LAN head, two heads. Two heads means how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Two heads. These are two heads. So that's why 4 over 8. Okay?
Okay.
Any question?
No.
Other girls, any question?
No.
That's it for today's class. See you at 12 o'clock after 1 hour for your science class.
Bye.
Bye-bye, girls. I'm exhausted.